The story begins by introducing two close friends, Mean and Tae-Soo, who are skilled fighters and successful in defeating opponents. However, their bond is tested when Mean learns he must transfer to a new school. Before parting, Mean shares his dream of owning the latest sports motorcycle, which seems impossible for him to afford such an expensive motorcycle. After moving to the new school, Mean faces the usual challenges of students testing his fighting prowess, including Hwan-Q. With his natural talent, Mean easily defeats Hwan-Q, making him a close friend replacing Tae-Soo, who is no longer with him. One day, Mean and Hwan-Q visit a bar, where Mean encounters Romi, a wealthy girl from the same school. Since that night, Mean and Romi have grown closer, although they both prioritize their studies and refrain from dating. They also make a pact to continue their education at the same campus after graduation. Meanwhile, Mean lives with his single mother, who often comes home drunk, leaving Mean feeling neglected. During a night exam at school, Tae-Soo surprises Mean with the sports motorcycle he once dreamed of. However, Tae-Soo, now a criminal, reveals he's been tasked with taking someone's life and gives the motorcycle to Mean as a parting gift before going to prison for a long time. As graduation day approaches, Romi, previously cheerful and optimistic about her studies, suddenly becomes sad. She refuses to discuss her troubles and suddenly transfers to another school, leaving Mean puzzled and stressed. When Hwan-Q is punished by a teacher, Mean's anger erupts, leading to both of them being expelled. This results in Mean being scolded by his neglectful mother in front of a man who happens to be his mother's lover and his prospective stepfather. Feeling abandoned, Mean decides to leave home with Hwan-Q. Meanwhile, Tae-Soo, still in prison, continues to send letters to Mean, his only friend. After a year passes, Mean and Hwan-Q find themselves working at a meat market with a quite arrogant boss who unfairly accuses people. Mean, still carrying a temper, decides to stand up to the boss and quits. Eager to continue their journey, they decide to open a food stall using Hwan-Q's parents' pension fund. On their opening day, Tae-Soo reappears, having been released from prison and officially joining elite mafia in the city, where Tae-Soo invites Mean and Hwan-Q to karaoke to have fun and collect overdue debts from the owner. After singing, Tae-Soo offers Mean a chance to join him in his line of work, citing his fighting talent. However, Mean, aware of the risks, chooses to stay on the right path and live a normal life. 2 weeks after opening their food stall, Mean and Hwan-Q face trouble when two thugs intending to collect monthly money under the pretext of security. When Hwan-Q was treated unpleasantly, that's when Mean's anger suddenly emerged, almost hitting the two thugs. However, Hwan-Q, who wants his business to continue, requests and pleads for Mean to restrain his emotions this time and follow the rules as applied in this area. Meanwhile, Tae-Soo intimidates an entrepreneur who refuses to pay, but they are interrupted by a rival mafia group, forcing Tae-Soo to flee. Mean and Hwan-Q face another problem when they learn that the land their stall is on is disputed and slated for government seizure. Despite paying the thugs for protection, they're left in a bind. Hwan-Q, who is not accepting his business being evicted, dares to injuring several officers around him, leads to his arrest, and the only way to release him is to settle with the victim's family, which requires money. Knowing this, Mean bravely goes to the thug's headquarters to ask for the money back. With the victim's family demanding an additional 100 million won for reconciliation, Mean finds himself short on cash. He reluctantly sells his cherished sports motorcycle, receiving only 30 million won. Despite his desire to stay away from crime, Mean has no choice but to seek help from Tae-Soo for a job to raise funds get Hwan-Q out of prison. In a building corridor, Tae-Soo's group faces off against their rivals. Each boss then selects their best fighter for a one-on-one duel. Mean, known for his fighting skills, represents Tae-Soo's group. Within a minute, Mean defeats his opponent, leading the rival group to concede and agree to cease interference. The mafia boss begins to like Mean and offers him a permanent position. However, once again, Mean has no intention of continuing and only does this one job to get the remaining money to redeem Hwan-Q out of prison. Once Hwan-Q is out of prison, they plan to find other ways to make a living. However, Mean receives a surprise message on his old pager, which he got from Romy when they first met at the bar. Romy had given it to him so they could stay in touch, promising not to give it to anyone else. Mean rushes to meet Romy at the same location they used to hang out together. Arriving at the place, Romy apologizes for leaving abruptly, explaining that her parents made her study in New York, and now she's back in her hometown. Mean is thrilled by this news, feeling happy to have Romy back. The next day, Romy suggests meeting at a different bar, wanting to drink heavily this time. She confesses that her departure wasn't just about studying abroad, it was because she suffered from severe depression due to her parents' pressure to conform to their wishes. Unable to bear it, she escaped and stayed with Mean and Huan-Q. Feeling sorry for her, Mean asks Tae-Soo for help to find a better place for both of them to live. Not only that, Romy, who is used to a comfortable lifestyle, asks for a fully furnished apartment, which Mean agrees to despite having to ask Tae-Soo for more money. However, in return, Mean has to work for Tae-Soo. On the other hand, Romy wants constant company and persuades Mean not to leave her alone. Mean feels burdened but has no choice, as Romy's troubles are now his to deal with. Although he reluctant to return to dirty work for Romy and to repay Tae-Soo's kindness, Mean reluctantly joins the gang to drive away protesting workers. However, upon arrival, Mean has a change of heart and wants to go home. Thanks to Tae-Soo's help, Mean survives the workers' attack and returns home injured. Unfortunately, Romy throws a tantrum and wants to leave because she feels abandoned. Despite his love for Romy, Mean persuades her to stay, but she leaves anyway. Feeling frustrated and angry, Mean joins Tae-Soo's gang and vents his frustration by brutally attacking their enemies. Meanwhile, Huan-Q is working as a waiter at a karaoke place that Mean often visits. He develops feelings for a singer there who also serves Mean, leading to a misunderstanding. Huan-Q mistakenly believes Mean has taken the woman he likes, sparking a big fight between them. Hurt by Mean's actions, Huan-Q returns the sports motorcycle that was sold for his freedom, wanting to sever ties with Mean and declaring the end of their friendship. Sometime later, when Huan-Q starts a new business, Mean attempts to reconcile. However, Huan-Q is deeply upset to learn that Mean dated the woman and even assaulted her in front of others. Huan-Q feels betrayed, believing a true friend would never do such things, especially not in public. Mean acknowledges his mistake in using the singer as a vent after Romy left. However, Huan-Q decides he can no longer be friends with Mean. This leaves Mean feeling abandoned, as he's now lost both Romy and his friend. Despite this, Tae-Soo remains by his side, but he's more focused on advancing his career. His ambition backfires when his boss discovers photos of him and Mean confronting the workers. These photos will clearly be strong evidence that could potentially expose the crimes of their group. Thus, rather than risk his business, the boss begins to consider kicking Tae-Soo out of the group. Back at their usual spot, Mean finds Romy unexpectedly showing up, revealing her feelings for him. They reconcile and head home together. Meanwhile, Tae-Soo and his men are seen working at one of the entertainment venues. The task given by the boss turns out to be a trap to kick out and eliminate Tae-Soo from the group. The boss even collaborates with their rival group to eliminate Tae-Soo and all his loyal followers. At the same time, one of Tae-Soo's men contacts Mean, alerting him to Tae-Soo's danger. So, for the second time, Mean reluctantly has to leave Romy alone to save his best friend. When he arrives, Tae-Soo is badly injured, outnumbered by the boss's men and their allies. Despite arriving too late, Mean tries to fight them off. The boss, showing some mercy, lets Mean take Tae-Soo, but Tae-Soo dies on the way to the hospital. Mean is heartbroken to lose his close friend in such a way. Refusing to let Tae-Soo's death, Mean speeds his motorcycle at high speed and returned to the scene to seek revenge. With his fighting skills, he was optimistic about wiping out all of the boss's henchmen. However, despite his fighting prowess, he meets the same fate as Tae-Soo. In his final moments, Romy speaks tenderly, asking Mean to come home soon and even requesting ice cream and snacks, unaware of his fate. And thus, Mean's story comes to an end. Moral lesson from the story: if someone offers you a motorcycle from a life of crime, make sure it comes with a warranty, unless you want to end up with a broken heart and a freezer full of snacks.